गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू माई चैनल दीदी की पढ़ाई। प्लीज फ्रेंड, बिफोर सीइंग माई वीडियो सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल। ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ साइंस क्लास 10, कार्बन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड्स। फ्रेंड्स, कार्बन हैज ए यूनिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कैटेनेशन। कैटेनेशन मीन्स लिंकिंग विथ ईच अदर कार्बन आइटम्स। इट कैन फॉर्म अ वेरी लॉन्ग चेन्स विद ईच अदर। सो वाई द कार्बन शोज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कैटेनेशन, और वाई इट मीन्स वॉट वी कॉल वाई इट वी डस कैटेनेशन, बिकॉज टू फुलफिल द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ इट्स ऑक्टेट और इलेक्ट्रॉन। Since carbon has atomic number 6, its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. The outermost shell of a carbon has 4 electrons. 4 electrons are present in the outermost shell. Which shell? Outermost shell has 4 electrons, outermost shell. To attain stability, it needs more. For stability, it needs more 4 electrons to achieve the nearest noble gas configuration, that is neon. Okay, so to gain this stability or to gain these 4 electrons, carbon shows the property of catenation or nothing but by sharing of electrons, and this sharing of electrons is known as covalent bond. Sharing of electrons between two atoms is called covalent bond. Okay, covalent bond. Yeah, remember that with this covalent bond, our topic also includes ionic bond. Which bond, students? Ionic bond. The ionic bonds are formed by the ions. That may be positive cations and negative anions. Positive cations and negative anions. The best example of ionic bond will be NaCl. NaCl, which is formed by Na plus sodium cation and Cl minus chloride anion. Okay, NaCl is formed by sodium cation and chloride ion. Okay, the ionic bond has high melting point and high boiling point. Okay, ionic bonding has high melting point and high boiling point. Remember this thing, it is very important in your higher classes when you study 11th and 12th. Okay, now let's start to know more about this covalent bond. We will take a example. See students, don't take care, I am just clearing your knowledge about what is meant by covalent bond. I will explain the lesson in detail. This is just introduction to carbon and its compound and the covalent bond and all about ionic bond, etc. Okay, now we'll take an example of hydrogen molecule formation. We know that the hydrogen molecule has atomic number 1 and its electronic configuration is 1s1, and this 1s1 is nothing but also called as in your book given as K shell. Okay, remember K shell. For knowing this about K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell, you have to subscribe my channel and see next videos. Okay, now concentrate. The hydrogen has one electron in its outermost orbit. It needs one more electron to achieve the nearest noble gas configuration, that is helium. Why? For stability, it needs one more electron. So what happens, students? This hydrogen atom combines with another hydrogen atom. The another hydrogen atom has also one electron in the outermost shell, and this hydrogen atom has also one electron in the outermost shell. So these two together share each electron with each other. They are one electron with each other, thus forming a covalent bond. The sharing of electron is known as covalent bond. Covalent bond is always formed between two atoms. It always shows sharing of electrons or pairing of electrons. That's also pairing of unpaired electrons. Just remember, it will come in higher classes. That is pairing of unpaired electrons makes what? Makes covalent bond. Pairing of unpaired electron makes covalent bond. Like this simple example, I would take one more example, that is Okay, like this, I would take one more example, that is of O2 molecule formation. O2 molecule formation. Since these examples are given in your NCERT book, okay? So we will strictly follow the NCERT. Yeah. O2 oxygen has atomic number 8 and its its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Okay. The outermost shell contains 6 electrons. 6 electrons are present in the valence shell. How many electrons? 6 electrons are present in the valence shell. To achieve the nearest to noble gas configuration, that is neon, of atomic number 10, it needs more, how many electrons? More 2 electrons to achieve stability or to achieve nearest to noble gas configuration. So, how does this oxygen compensate the loss of electron? Same way, this also office. So I will show this electrons. These are electrons of oxygen, outermost electron shell, okay, and this is another oxygen. These two oxygens fulfill their requirement by sharing of their electrons. See, the oxygen 1 share electrons with the oxygen 2, and oxygen 2 shares its electron with the oxygen with the first oxygen. So here is a covalent bond formation. You can see here that there are two covalent bonds, and in chemistry such bonds are called as pi bonds. Which bonds? Pi bonds denoted by pi. Or they are also called as double bonds. Which bonds, friends? Double bonds. They are nothing but the covalent bonds. These double bonds are nothing but the covalent bonds, okay? So don't get confused. These double bonds are nothing but the covalent bonds. And in case of hydrogen molecule, this covalent bond is called as single bond. What are which bond, students? Single bond, okay? Single bond, and in the case of oxygen, double bond, okay? So, double bond also contains pi bond. That is, one pi bond. One pi bond contains one sigma bond. One pi bond contains... We generally call single bond as a sigma bond. We generally call the single bond as sigma bond, and we denote the sigma bond as Greek letter. Okay. Continue. One pi bond means one sigma bond plus one pi. Okay. Remember these things. So students, we will stop here today, and we will continue the triple bond formation. Which bond? Triple bond formation of nitrogen, a very important case, triple bond formation case of nitrogen, in our next part 2. Okay. Hey, before going, please subscribe my channel Didiki Padai for class 10 NCERT and extra questions. I will give you everything you require. Please commit me. Okay, bye.